What is the first thing in agriculture outputs?
Harvesting.
Harvesting, you will get the produce, and that should be part of that produce is kept by the farmers for their subsistence, and rest should be sold, marketed. Where this market? Where the, ideally where should it be marketed?
Urban areas.
Urban areas, APMCs. See, soon after independence, the power to market agriculture produce is given to the states. But state should give production to market the agriculture produce, because otherwise if the production is not given, already the farmers are into the clutches of the moneylenders. Moneylenders charging high interest rate. If that is not produced, if that is not marketed, what will happen? They will quote very less price for the farmers producing. Already farmers are pushed into the burden of paying high interest rate, and they will not be able to generate high price for their produce. So to give the market protection to the agriculture produce, Constitution of India given them, given this power to states to market this produce, market and buying this produce. What is that system? The APMCs, Agriculture Produce Marketing Committees. APMCs, Agriculture Produce Marketing Committees. And the control, regulation and control of agriculture activities also given to the state, put under state list. Seventh schedule, what is the second list?
State list.
The item number 14, agriculture. Item number 28, agriculture, marketing. Now the states can legislate laws related to agriculture and agriculture marketing also. So APMC is the first point of sale. First point of sale of the farmers, of the farmers. First point of the sale. The first sale should happen here. First sale should happen at APMCs. So how this happen? First point of sale. APMC itself is the Agriculture Produce Market Committee. So the agriculture markets are maintained by the committee members are trustees. Trustees are committee. They are appointed by the government. They are appointed or nominated or elected. So based on the APMC's acts enacted by the different states. Since it is item number 14, item number 28 is agriculture marketing. 28. So respective states enacted APMC acts. Based on the different state governments acts, but there are certain common points regarding the organization and working of the APMCs. So these APMCs are operated and maintained by a committee or trustees. And they will appoint commission agents. They will give license to commission agents. And this commission agent is responsible for bringing farmers' produce into the market yard and display that, in case if it is needed, it is sorted, graded, cleaned, dried and displayed. And then he will arrange for auctioning. He will arrange for auctioning. Now buyers will buy that produce. Whoever quotes the highest price, they will buy that. And again that produce is again graded, packaged, weighed and sold to the buyers. Sold to the buyers, and buyers will pay market fee. So two types of sales happen the APMCs. One is the primary sale, second is secondary sale. Two types of sale. What will happen in primary sale? Primary sale, producers will bring that produce to the APMCs and and that is acts on, and buyer will buy. On buyer to buyer, secondary sale is from buyer to buyer. Secondary sale is from buyer to buyer happen. Primary sale, producer to buyer. So in this, during this sale or auctioning process, there will be number of fees collected. Entry fees, exit fees, market fees, and buy, entry fees and exit fees and commission agent fees paid by the entry fees and commission agent fees paid by the commission agent, market fee and exit fee paid by the buyers. Apart from that, maintenance fee, other fees are paid to the APMCs. This is how APMC get the income. So what will, if you see the block diagram, the basic activities at APMC is agriculture produce. So they will bring that agriculture produce to APMCs, inbound to APMC or market yard, APMC or market yard. This will what happen? This second step, third step, sorted, graded, dried, right, displayed for auction, third is auction, by the buyer. Who will arrange this auction? Commission agent. This is responsible for the commission agent. Commission agent responsible for this, and this is auctioner, another office person called auctioner or generally dami. He will arrange for auctioning. Then it is weighed and packaged and given to the buyer. So buyer will pay market fee. The fourth step, either it can go out of this. What's happening? Graded, dried. In case if it is necessary, dried. Then buyer will pay. It will go for secondary sale or exit. So outbound trade. So all this happens at MSP. So government announces MSP. Based on the quality of the agriculture produce, the farmers will realize MSP at the APMCs. These are the steps involved. Now, are the farmers benefiting from APMCs? All the steps are followed in all states? All these steps are followed in all states? No. What are the problems with APMCs? Who are producing? Commission agents coming to
farm.
Yes. So what the problem is, first of all, the market committee people are appointed, they are not experts in agriculture produce. They are not experts in agriculture activities and agriculture marketing. Who are the market committee members? They are experts in politics. The people who work at the lower level, village level political activists, if they don't get either Sarpanch or MPTC, they will be appointed as market committee member. Right? They are politically appointed. So these commission agents are also, most of the times they are politically appointed. And there is a close relationship between the commission agents and market committee. So they siphon off the funds. What are the problems? So most of the farmers are not benefited from this APMC system. Most of the farmers, because there are certain problems. That is why this Farm Act, three Farm Acts were brought. Three Farm Acts were brought because there have been certain inherent problems in the APMCs. Because close relationship with the commission agents and committee members, market committee. What they do? Most of the time these commission agents lead to the cartel each other. They form the syndicate. And they control the prices. They lead to hoarding. So whatever price they quote, that should be buyer should be bought that price. They control the price. They will decide the prices at the APMCs. So the farmers are not able to get, even if they take the produce to the agriculture market ad, farmers are not able to get good prices because of these commission agents deciding the prices. They are deciding the prices because they are forming, all the commission agents forming a syndicate. They are forming a cartelling, and they are also sometimes they are also hoarding that produce, which is not being released into the market. So inflation is high. Sometimes inflation is high. So when inflation is high, prices are high, they are releasing into the market to get more profit. They are itself acting as buyers. Sometimes commissioner itself acting as buyers and resorting to hoarding. Right. And then when the fluctuations in the agriculture produce, when there is more inflation, when prices are high, they are releasing into the market so as to get more profits. This is second problem. Like I said, these committee members are not experts in agriculture. Committee members are not experts in agriculture activities or agriculture marketing or value addition of this agriculture activities also. Agriculture activities are produce marketing or value addition to this. So that what they can do? Vertical integration of the agriculture produce. What do you mean by the vertical integration? Vertical integration of the agriculture produce. Because of this, what will happen in vertical integration of the agriculture produce? They buy the produce, they value add it, process it, and they export it. Food processing. Vertical integration of agricultural produce is food processing. They are not experts. They don't know because they are politically appointed. They lack the expert. Second, they collect number of fees. Entry fees, exit fees, commission agent fees, marketing fees. All these fees, they should be utilized for improving the infrastructure facilities at the APMCs. 90% of the APMCs in India doesn't have proper storing facilities. Remember that most of the agriculture produce are perishable. What do you mean by perishable? They'll get destroyed. In 2-3 days, most of these, if you see the horticulture produce, there are no storing facilities and there are no processing facilities. The farmers will be in a hurry to sell this produce as soon as possible to reduce the wastage. In that situation, what will happen? Whatever the price quoted at the market yards, that will be the remuneration to the farmers. Because the negotiation powers, they are getting only raw deal. Because of this perishability of the nature of the agriculture produce, and because of lack of storage facilities, cold storage facilities or processing facilities at the market yards, because the fees collected by them are not utilized, because since they are politically appointed, they are siphoning of the income of the market yards. Leakage of the market, siphoning of. siphoning of the fees, fees and taxes collected at market yard. Because of this, there is no improvement in the infrastructure facilities. Infrastructure facilities at the market yard. Since market yard allows open-ended procurement, what do you mean by open-ended procurement? Private players are allowed. That is not open-ended procurement. Open-ended procurement is there is no minimum quantity restrictions that can be taken to the APMCs. However, most of the APMC markets are quite far from the producers, agriculture farm gates. Some APMCs are located near to 40 to 50 kilometers, and there are no transportage facilities. Most of the farmers produce very minimal agriculture produce. Even though it allows open-ended procurement, they cannot take that to APMCs and wait for weeks until their turn comes. In that meanwhile, if there are any rains or cyclones, what will happen? Entire produce will get destroyed. And there are no facilities for them to take rest at the market yard also. And if they had to wait for days in market yards, what about the other agriculture activities in this? Most of the farmers, what they are thinking, that let it be, even it is lesser price, let the produce be sold at the farm gate itself. Because all the burden of taking that produce to the market yard and waiting for that, paying market fees, commissionation fees, and then getting very low, getting lesser price than what we expected. The farmers thinking, let the produce be sold to the middleman itself. The lack of transportation facilities and most of the quite distance from the farm, distance from the farmers. Distance is the you see, entire India we have only some 2,700 plus market yards, APMCs. 2,700 plus primary market yards and some around 4,500 plus sub-primary, sub-market yards. And quite distance from them. And lack of transportation facilities. So all these reasons, the APMC system in India has been utterly a failure. Neither it is benefiting farmers nor consumers. Government is giving MSP and procured by the procured at the APMCs by the FCI or other private players to control the prices of the agriculture produce. Government is giving subsidies to the farmers and subsidies to the consumers. Why? What is the ultimate aim? Is to bring down the prices of the agriculture produce. Bring down the prices, because ultimate aim of the government of India is socialism. Socialism is the ultimate aim. What do you mean by socialism? Socioeconomic welfare and development. To achieve this target, agriculture prices are controlled. But meanwhile, farmers are affected. What do you mean by socialism? Take the surplus from the rich person and redistribute among the poor person. But to achieve that socialism, you are punishing farmers. Isn't it? You are in the name of APMCs and MSP, farmers are net losers here. Because the prices are controlled and APMC monopoly has been maintained, farmers have become net losers here. Net losers, they are not getting proper out remuneration for their produce. Because of this, one of the reason was APMCs. So to reduce the challenges in the APMCs, government from time to time has been bringing some reforms. The first in that direction was Model Agriculture APMC produce Model Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee Act 2003. Model APMC Act 2003. Model APMC Act 2003. So here small private players and farmer cooperative societies can procure at the farm gate level. So see, central government cannot induce this act, cannot force the states to enact this Model APMC Act. What central government can do? It can suggest the state government, it can recommend the state government to enact this Model APMC Act, because the power to regulate APMCs lies in the hands of state government. So central government enacted this Model APMC Act in 2003. What it did, it allowed procurement by the small private players and the farmer cooperative societies. Procurement by the small private players at the village level, farm gate level, small private players and cooperatives at the village level, at the farm gate level itself. Second, it allows for contract farming, giving a space to private sector in the farming activities, allowed for the contract farming. So what this contract farming? Let private players approach the farmers before the sowing itself, have a negotiation with the farmers. Let price assurance given to the farmers. The prices for the agriculture produce is assured before the sowing season by the private players. Even if it is more than MSP, sometimes it is more than MSP also. The contractors will give some input subsidies or inputs to the farmers, or they can have, like, let's take the example of PepsiCo company. They have Lays. You know that Lays? So they had contract with the farmers of Punjab and Gujarat, Punjab, Haryana and Gujarat farmers. What this, the contracted certain farmers and they gave some varieties of potatoes. So that can be used in production of Lays. So such type of contract would be beneficial to the company, the corporate companies as well as the farmers. So it allowed the contract farming so that for better negotiation of the farmers and the better prices for the farmers. So but this is only 16 states agreed for this, but not even then it is not implemented in all states. Model APMC Act was also not implemented in all states. And then in 2017, government came up with another act called Model Agriculture Produce and Livestock Marketing Act. So now this act integrated agriculture along with livestock. So Model APMC, Model Agriculture Produce and Livestock Act. Livestock Produce, Model Agriculture Produce and Livestock Produce Act 2007. So what this act included, all the provisions in the Model APMC Act 2003. Apart from that, this also with the production of livestock produce. What are the livestock produce? Production to marketing, production to livestock produce. What are the livestock produce? poultry, piggery, goatry, right, other dairy products, along with this horticulture also. Fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables are also allowed this in the marketing of Model APMC Act. So this also most of the governments are not willing to, state governments are not willing to agree for this, because they think that agriculture and agriculture market is in state list. Why should we agree to the directions given by the recommendations given by the central government? So in this direction, in this scenario, when this is happening, last year they bought 3 farms act during the corona. As part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, they bought 3 farms act. That is important.